Hello viewers, welcome to Junsori Tutorial Channel. I am Abdul Genius Jallo, the sponsor and the coordinator of this wonderful channel. I also doubles as the founder and executive director of the Student Foundation, UNIMAC. I believe you may have a great lesson.
Hello everyone, my name is Joseph Malik Conte. For this class today, we are going to look at the module which is University Studies. Under this class, which is Lesson 1, we are going to look at what is a university. And we also look at the functions of a university. Now, we're looking onto the concept of what is a university. A general view. We narrow it down to the University of Makeni, or we narrow it down to different colleges within Sierra Leone. When looking onto a university, we say a university, it is an institution of higher learning. It is an institution of higher learning which is designed for instruction and an examination for students within that particular university. What does this mean? Looking onto an institution of higher learning. Within this institution, you gain your level of education goes higher than how it was in the primary and the secondary level. Looking onto your secondary and primary level, the method, the means in which you were taught is more different from the way presently they are teaching you at the university level. Now, it is designed for instruction and examination. For every university, they play a role in which they conduct exam and they instruct students the way how they go about the administrative, their studies, their lectures, and how effective students should be towards coming to classes for lecturers to teach them or to lecture them during classes. In terms of examination, for every university, there must be an examination. How does some university conduct these exams? It can be oral and it can be written. The oral, some of us normally do presentation within our classes, and the written aspect, some of us normally do the exams at the auditorium or the classroom or test. They normally do this examination for them to assess the performance of students, for them to know the level of understanding of students within a particular university. Because you can't be teaching students without testing them or without assessing them or without evaluating them on how or on what you have taught them during the past 2 to 3 months. Now, they also look at the concept, say a university is a liberal. A liberal arts and science. What does this mean? A liberal heart. A university is a liberal heart. Looking onto so many universities within Sierra Leone, the liberal heart, you have the social science department, you have the literature department, you also have the psychological department, and you also have the physiological department, in which most of the time they train students within this area or within this department for them to know how to communicate well, for them to know how to discuss issues within the environment, within the society. That's looking onto liberal heart. And you also looking onto liberal heart is the aspect of designing, drawing, and the likes. Looking onto science, you have certain courses or certain departments within the university, like the public health. The public health is one of the most important departments from the science axis, in which they embark on issues of dealing with health and the likes, how human beings need to take care of their environment for them to be free from disease and the likes. Now, they also make it clear that a university conferred a professional degree. Now, looking on to saying a university conferred a professional degree. A professional degree is a degree someone acquires directly from the university without having issues going through the broader curriculum and the likes. So therefore, looking on to this conferred professional university, at the end of every student courses conducted for students or going through your course, after every 4, 5, 6 years, the university will provide you with a degree. This degree will satisfy the university that you have gone through their process, you have gone through their curriculum, so you are well equipped for what you are going to do in the global world. So looking onto this, you look at the university. They also made mention that a university deals with a broader curriculum. A broader curriculum, automatically looking onto the university, you can see students within the science department. They taught them certain things or certain modules based on ethics, based on integral development, based on sociology, just for you to understand. Your level of understanding needs to be broad. Your level of understanding needs to be large. Because mind you, going out to the world for you to acquire your job or for you to secure a job, you need to deal with certain people. You need to deal with ethical issues, which going through this broader curriculum will help you for you to deal with the global world going out of the university. It's what we look at, say, a university. Mind you, for us to go to or for us to have a recap, say a university is an institution of higher learning, which is designed for instruction and examination for students. We also say a university comprises of both the liberal heart and science, which we made mention of liberal heart, the aspect of heart, we made mention of social science, and we also made mention of sociology. Now we look onto the conferred professional degree. The conferred professional degree, for every student, after going through the process, after going through the stages, or the final stage for you to graduate, the university give you a certificate which will satisfy the university that you have gone through all the stages. Are you looking onto a broader curriculum? For every university, they have a broader curriculum which they look onto modules, they look onto issues that are not even relevant to your course. But for you to think broadly, because of you are going to face the global world, they want you to think broadly and deal with issues that are not even related to your course. This is what they refer to as a university. Thank you. Now, looking onto the concept of the function of the university, what do we understand about the functions of a university? Function may be referred to as the role. Function may be referred to as the responsibility. So now, looking on to the responsibility of a university. Now, They are also referred to as the key mandate of every university. Now, looking onto this concept, a key mandate, the role of a university, the responsibility of a university, the function of a university, we have in threefold. First of all, we say a university teach, it's the responsibility of the university to teach, to conduct a research, and community and community service. Now, for every university, you can't have a university without teaching students. You can't have a university without telling the students what are the importance of certain issues. Now they teach you based on your modules. They teach you based on how to deal with people, how to interact with people. They even teach people how they think that they can go out in their offices and be a productive and a smart and effective worker in their workplace. Now looking on to research, one of the key role, one of the most important factors that will help a university improve, that will help. As I said earlier, research is one of the key role, one of the key factors that will help a university improve in terms of their standard, in terms of their opportunities. Research, all about research is about you going out or looking on to try to know some of the issues that are affecting the university, some of the things that will help to improve the university. Try to gain new ideas, and that will lead the university to be more productive, for the university to know their weakness, their strength, opportunities and threats. So therefore, they will try to work on the issues which will help the university be improved in terms of standard of education and maintain their potential. Now looking on to community service, you have a lot of departments that are within the university that provide community service to different communities. Most times the departments that often provide community service within the university is the Department of Social Science, because the Department of Social Science is geared towards providing an harmonious skill, trying to provide a way for them to know how they think they could render a service to the people, to provide a way how they think that they would identify the problems, try to find a way how they could provide means of communication towards these people within the society they live, within the community they live. So when looking onto the roles of functions and responsibility of the university, these are the roles and functions of the university. So now for this next lesson also, we are going to look at the differences between a university and a college. The differences between a university and a college, mind you, as we made it earlier on, under the concept or under what is a university. Now, we look onto, say, a university is included with a more body student. Or a large student body. Now looking onto a more body student or a large student body, or we are in made mention, this within every university, the university have a large body of students which comprises of the ministers, the presidents and the likes. And whilst we are talking on to the colleges, they have a minute or a small number of a student body which can represent the students in any issues. We also look at a university involve a broader curriculum. a university involves a broader curriculum. Let's take a comparison between the University of Makeni and some other colleges within Makeni. The University of Makeni involves broader curriculum, which the curriculum is very large. And mind you, looking onto colleges like Kuma, colleges like OIC, they limit their curriculum to certain modules, to certain courses. So therefore, that's another differences between the university and the college. The broader curriculum within a university and whilst the college have a smaller curriculum. Now, we make mention by saying a university, they confer a graduate degree or a graduate professional degree. A university provide a graduate professional degree, and whilst the colleges, they only provide diplomas, certificates, and the like. So these are some of the differences between the university and the colleges. And mind you, you also look at some of the administrative issues within the university. The university administrative issues are very broad, and whilst taking onto some other colleges, while the administrative issues are very small. So looking onto this, this is the main difference between a university and a college. Guys, this is the end of lesson one. Mind you, lesson one, for just a recap, we deal with what is a university, functions of a university, which we also refer to as the key mandate, the roles and responsibilities of a university. And last week, we deal with the differences between the university and the college. Thank you all for listening. Once more, we meet again in lesson two.